up on the Auburn 43, and they've got to get to the 47 for a first down. Three wideouts. A lone running back. The quarterback underneath. Third down, four, Auburn. Cox back to pass. Fires immediately. We intercepted on our 48-yard line, and one of our own backs knocked our back down on their 47. Paul Oliver intercepted the ball, and one of our defensive backs came up two strides later and hit him right in the back, and down they both went, but the Dogs got the ball. Young Paul Oliver intercepted. We are going backwards because we are not strong enough. Sutherland and Ware, the two backs. We got one wide out. It's third down. Four for a touchdown. One man slotted right. Now another man flanks wide out to the left. And so Shockley looks and looks and looks. And he's scrambling now for his life. And he's going to throw a ball. And touchdown! He got it in the corner to Pope. Big Pope went up in the air. Shockley was running back for his life, running backwards. Threw a ball that I thought was gone nuts. And Pope went up and caught it in a sitting position about 8 yards deep in the end zone near the corner. We got a touchdown. It looked like he was going to throw the ball away, but he was actually, I think, looking at Pope all the way. And so it's 9-7, 4:50. Well, now you're goal to go on the nine, but you're still behind. Dogs walk up to the line of scrimmage. Brown and Sutherland are in an I formation. Shockley is under the center. We have two wideouts. Auburn brings up, they got five men on the line. Shockley straightens and looks, going to throw it in the corner. Massacre, touchdown. We just put Massacre one-on-one on one defender, and he threw the ball accurately enough to give it over the defender's hands and into the arms and the chest of Massacre. So we lead by five little points, 19-14. Goal to go, and we're down 21-20. Goal to go. McClendon goes out to the right, the only receiver. We are in a power set otherwise. Auburn's in a five. Shockley underneath, one of the tight end slides in motion. Toss sweep. Thomas Brown trying to get outside of the 5-4-3-2. Touchdown!
Good-looking drive by the Dogs. They went 82 yards. They started at their 18 after the punt. Eight plays.
But the lead is 5 points. That's a funny-sounding lead. I agree, Louie. They might go for two. It looks like they moved the ball to the hash mark already. We are going to gamble and go for two.
Yeah, we're going to call a timeout, I believe, to discuss it.
Auburn up to the line. Aren't there any old junkyard dogs sitting in a stadium somewhere? We can give them a helmet. Underneath his Cox, he's going to give it to Irons. Irons to the corner. One man hanging on. They barely pull him down. He fumbled as he got to the sideline. And they may give us a ball. There's a big pileup. The Dogs think they got the ball. The Dogs think we got the ball.
Owens has it. He just handed it to the official.
There's still no sign, though. Wait a minute. This may not be funny. This could be the whole night right here. There's still a pileup. The Dogs think we have the ball. Hang on.
Covered by Georgia. First down.
Yeah, we got the ball. We got the ball. Tony Taylor was a guy that may have caused the fumble. We got the ball. Well, that was almost a junkyard dog thing. Punched the ball on the replay. Mentor punched the ball. Tony Taylor then grabbed him. We have got the ball way back on the 11. What are they going to do? Do a review on it? Auburn might ask for a review. I don't know, you guys.
Well, it was definitely a fumble. You could see that on the review. Now, they may be trying to see whether or not it was out of bounds, but Jeffrey Owens came out of the pile. He had the football. for Georgia.
Now I'm trying to look at it.
Okay, looking at the replay, Irons is not down when the ball came out. The official throws the beanbag, and then that's when the scramble begins for the football. And from the angle we're looking at, you can't really see.
No, the ball was close
to recovering
it,
or where the sideline is.
Oh, that's going to be a tough review. Whoever loses this review is going to really be mad.
Well, the thing is, too, it has to be, conclusive evidence to overrule what they said on the field,
yeah.
And they've already said it's Georgia football.
Well, that may not mean anything.
Got to have faith in the striped shirts.
Is that right?
I can't believe I just said that.
I can't either believe that you just said that. Well, we asked for a hero, and then we asked for an old junkyard dog to come out of the stadium somewhere and help the defense. And now here we are. We're looking at the replay. That's a better angle. There's the ball. No, I think we were inbound. That's why we're all hollering and waving. We're watching the replay. They're playing it over and over. I like the other angle better than the one they just played. Oh, man.
Now, Owens came out of the pile with the ball, but, I mean, he was out of bounds, clearly, when he struggled out of the pile. I don't know how you determine who had possession in that pile.
If they got the ball.
But they've already said Georgia has the ball, so they can't. By that replay, they can't give it back to Auburn because the evidence is not clear.
Yeah, but you're trying to make common sense out of it. Oh, man. Oh, do you think this isn't big? Holy smokes.
Oh, it's only a spot in the SEC championship on the line.
Okay.
After further review, Georgia did gain possession of the ball in play.
Yeah, we got the ball. Well, we won a review and we've lost the review. We've got the ball now. Was that old lady luck? We've got the ball in our 11. Can we block anybody or are we too tired? This game is by no means over. We got a 27-21 lead. We barely got the ball. We had to look at pictures to get the ball. On the 11-yard line, Shockley underneath. Takes it. They're coming on him. He dumps a pass, and it is complete to the fullback who fumbled after he hit the ground. There's a pileup, and Auburn man has picked it up and gone down in the goal, and they're going to give them a touchdown on a recovery pickup by Deribi Didi. Sutherland caught a pass coming across the 15. As he went down, the ball popped up, and an Auburn linebacker just like that, they tear your heart out, streaks in there about 18, 20 yards for a touchdown. It happened so fast, half the members on both squads did not know it was going on. Because the fumble was right over here by this sideline, and the play started out in the middle. And Auburn now is in a tie, 27-27 with us. And the Dogs have fumbled that thing right back. And Auburn now has a chance to get the lead again. 9:28 to go. Now what are you going to do? It will be fourth down and 10.5. Auburn's getting the play signal to them from the bench. The ball is back in the Auburn 34.5. They need about 11 yards to keep the drive going so they can come down and kick a field goal and beat us. It's 30-28, Georgia. Here's fourth down. Now, where are they going to go? They're going to go with Irons? Or are they going to go at that one corner? Where are they going to go? Cox is in a shotgun. Is there an old junkyard dog somewhere? Cox waiting. Cox took a low snap. Now he's coming back. He's got time. He's throwing. There's a man open on our 35. He got away to the 30, the 25, the 20. We're going to chase him. And I don't know if we got him. We got him maybe an inch or so from the goal line. We chased him all the way in the corner.
Oh, they just...
Anthony Mix. Two officials are talking about it down there. They're wondering if he scored before he went out.